Hey, it's me, Ghillie again, and this time, I'm not driving around my Night Shark like I typically would. Today I'm driving around another vehicle that in my opinion is far too underrated for what it offers. That vehicle is the Half-Track, and in this video I'm going to show you exactly why the Half-Track is so amazing. The Half-Track offers much of the same uses as the Night Shark, which I do praise a lot, you guys know. For starters, its explosive resistance is the exact same as the Night Shark. The Half-Track will take 27 homing missiles to blow up, so one Oppressor Mark II is not going to stop you in this thing. However, the Half-Track will protect you much better against bullets. You can equip armor plating over the windows, but I recommend keeping them stocked so that you can throw sticky bombs out of the windows, because this will remain a good weapon to use against Oppressor Mark IIs as the driver. Now, you're probably confused as to why I'm saying it offers more protection from bullets when the windshield is visibly huge and completely unprotected. Well, from the eyes, yes, the windshield looks clear as day with no protection. But if you actually try to shoot someone out of the Half-Track from the front windows, it is impossible to kill them. I'm not exactly sure if this is intentional or not, but it's been that way since release. And not even the FMJ rounds can pierce through the front windows. A majority of the player base does not even know that these windows are bulletproof, so what you can do is use this to your advantage by going up to people and just watching them try to shoot you out of the front. It's quite comedic. On top of that though, it's also completely bulletproof from the back, so the only place you can actually get shot out of the Half-Track from are the side windows. Knowing this information, you can position the Half-Track in a place where you will almost never be shot out in PvP and PvE scenarios, and is the reason why the Half-Track is one of the best defensive vehicles in the game, both from bullets and explosives. The Half-Track doesn't only come with amazing defense though, it also has some offensive capabilities like the quad machine gun, the equipable proximity mines, which can be spammed forever because you have unlimited of them, and the roller located on the front of the vehicle. Let's start out by discussing its turret. The Half-Track's quad guns are one of the strongest turrets in the entire game. It's capable of decimating unarmored vehicles in a matter of seconds. Cop vehicles will blow up in just a couple of seconds of constant fire. Comparing its power against the Insurgent Pickup Custom minigun in a 1v1, you can see, although it is a very long battle because they're two really armored vehicles, the Half-Track does come out on top and blows up the Insurgent. If you went up against this turret thinking you could maybe auto-aim the guy off of it, think again, because as long as the gunner is looking at its target, they are completely protected. The only way to shoot the gunner off with bullets is to shoot them from the backside because they are completely exposed back there. Explosives are a different story though. The Half-Track acts kind of weird in this situation. If you're operating the gun solo with no one else in the vehicle, and the vehicle gets hit with any type of explosion, you're gonna die. But the moment someone gets in the driver's seat, you become immune to explosions on the gun. It's really weird why it works like this, but it's just something you need to be aware of. The cylindrical thing on the front of the Half-Track is what is called an unditching roller. Now, in real life, this would be used to prevent the vehicle from getting stuck in things like ditches, as the name suggests. Well, in GTA, it can help you prevent getting stuck in things like roadblocks. Based on my own experience, the Half-Track can shove cop cars out of the way as long as you T-bone them. It's like the moment you ram the side of a cop vehicle, this magical force like pushes them away. The only downside I can think of for the Half-Track is its speed. It's not very fast at all, so you're not going to be outrunning anything in it, but the proximity mines that it can drop can help take out anyone that tries to get close to you. And even if they do get close to you, that's where its grade A defense comes into play. If you want to own this vehicle, it's going to set you back about $1.7 million before all of the upgrades. Kind of expensive, but for this week only, it is on the podium at the Diamond Casino where you will have a chance to win it for free. Anyways, that is everything you guys need to know about the Half-Track. If you enjoyed the video or found it helpful, feel free to leave a like as well as subscribe to my channel for more guide and PvP related content. And as always, thanks for watching and have a great day.